So let's solve question number 4. The question they have asked that, describe the measures taken by the government of India to tackle the problems of black money. So the question is, let me write the question, describe the measures taken by government of India to tackle the problem of black money. To what, and the other part, and the second part of the question is, to what extent these measures are successful in addressing the problem? To what measures? To what extent these measures are successful? Okay. So let's solve this question. So you know that the government of India has taken several measures to tackle the problem of this black money, which refers to income that has been obtained illegally or not reported to the tax authorities. So in the first part, we have to define the black money. What is black money? What is the feature of black money? That the black money refers to the income that has been obtained illegally. So, income that has been obtained illegally, okay, and or not reported to the tax authorities, or you can define it as not reported to the authorities. Okay, so in the beginning of the question, just define the just define what is black money. Now we will discuss the some significant steps which was taken by government of India. So the steps were, the first steps, we all know that the government of India introduced the concept of demonetization in November 2016. So first step was demonetization. Iska matlab hai notbandi. So in November 2016, the government of India announced the demonetization of rupees 500 and 1000 currency notes. And so the date is important, November 2016. And India announced the demonetization, or they banned the note of rupees 500 and rupees 1000 note. Okay. So the aim was to curb the circulation of black money and reduce corruption. So the government also encouraged people to deposit their cash into the bank accounts and offered amnesty of for those who declared their undisclosed income. So the demonetization was a bold and biggest step in the recent years that the government of India took to control the problem of black money. So demonetized the black money system. The 500 rupees and 1000 rupees note. The second controlling steps or measure was the Benami Transaction Act. Second was Benami Transaction Prohibition Act. What does it mean? It means that the government enacted the Benami Transaction Act in 2016. It also aims to prevent the people from holding property in someone else's name to avoid paying taxes. Okay, so this act was implemented in 2016. And what was the aim? The aim of this act was to prevent people from holding property. To prevent people from holding property in someone else's name to avoid paying tax. Okay. So, under this act, the government can confiscate the properties purchased through Benami transactions. So, it was the authority that government of India had. The next step was Black Money and Imposition of Tax Act. Black money in bracket undisclosed foreign income and asset. Undisclosed foreign income and assets and imposition of tax act is a very important. It should remember this. It should remember the concept of this act. This act was enacted in the year of 2015. Okay, this is very important. Why it was enacted? To deal with the problem of black money held by Indians in foreign countries. To deal with the problem of black money held by Indian in foreign. You know the concept of Swiss bank. So the law requires people to disclose their foreign assets and pay taxes on them, failing which they could face prosecutions. So this act actually emphasizes that every person who are holding money for in their foreign account or foreign NRI Indians, so they had to pay tax to the government of India. Otherwise, they had to be face any kind of serious trouble. So the next point was, or the next step was, tax information exchange agreements. The next important step was tax information exchange agreements. In short form, we say it as TIEAS. Okay, so the government has signed TIEAs with various countries to obtain information on Indians holding assets abroad. So these agreements aim to prevent tax evasion and the accumulation of black money in foreign countries. So the government has signed this with various countries. So TIEAs was signed with various countries to prevent tax evasion. Because to obtain information on Indians holding assets. So you know about the con you are you can watch a documentary named Black Bad Boy Billionaire streamed in Netflix, and there they described about the Nirav Modi and Vijay Mallya, and you can observe the flight of capital from this country. There is a huge issue of black money in that segment also. So these are some important steps which was taken by our government to prevent this problem. Okay, so to some extent these measures have been successful in addressing the problem of black money. So the second part of this question was to what extent this was successful. So we have defined the black money, then we have discussed about the demonetization, the Penami Transaction Act, the Black Money and Imposition of Tax Act, TIEs. Okay, so these are numerous steps which was taken by our government of India to control the problem of black money. Now we have to assess that whether these steps were successful or not. So assessment, in the case of assessment, we can say that the measures were successful. The measures have been successful. You can give the example like demonetization, the success of demonetization. So, like for instance, demonetization led to a significant increase in the number of people filing income tax returns. which suggests that more people are now reporting their income. Similarly, NIV Transaction Act, Black Money and Imposition of Tax Act, this has made it difficult for people to hold properties and assets in some else's name. So, various acts influence people to file income tax. Okay. But however, these measures alone cannot entirely solve the problem of black money. It requires a sustained effort to reduce corruption, improve transparency, and make the tax system simpler and more efficient. So the government needs to work towards a more comprehensive approach to tackle the problem of black money, because we have only by imposing various kind of act cannot stop this problem of black money 100%. It can reduce it. They're reducing the problem of black money, but decreasing corruption is another object, and the sustained effort to reduce corruption is needed. Sustained effort to reduce. You can write this part as your suggestion to government, or so that the government can perform more efficiently to control this black money, to reduce this corruption. Okay, so this is the entire structure of this answer of this question number 4. So you can apply all these points, you can use all this, you can name all this act and mention the date and year. It will be very easy for you to answer this question. So thank you.